Hello everyone, it's Travis again, checking in from the airport. It's about 5:30 in the morning. I have a plane at 6:45 bound from here to Detroit, and then I'll get on yet another long flight from North America to Asia. I'll arrive in Japan on there Sunday at about 2:30 p.m. It's about a 13-hour flight, I think, from Detroit this time. And yeah, here we go again, another adventure in the world travels of your boy Tiberius.
Well, here we are. I'm in Narita International Airport in the train station, waiting on the trains. I'll give you a quick look around. That it's not much to see because we're underground now. You can all these trains have these little food kiosks there, vending machines and kiosks and stuff like that, big in Japan. So my train is at 4:19. I've got about 20 or 30 minute wait for my train, but I chose the train that goes from here straight to Shibuya, which is where I'm gonna stay, so I don't have to change trains at all. So I got my ticket. The train system here is like a wonder of the modern world. It's so accurate and everything that it's really something to see if you ever make it to Japan, the accuracy with which they can run these trains. So I'll check in again from Shibuya from my hotel.
Y'all missed all my laughing when I tried to do this before because my phone gave out on me. But okay, let's see if you smart alecks can figure out this. This is a sink, apparently. A faucet, actually. It has an end that goes into the sink, which you can see here. It has a long tube that goes into the shower that you may see here. And, yeah. Anybody want to give me your best bet? Let me zoom down on this bad boy and give you a good look. 360-degree view so you can all tell me how dumb I am, okay? There's three knobs that I can see here. It has, let me see if I can hold my phone. I don't have the easiest cover here. It has a knob on top. It has a knob on the front. And it has a knob on the side. And this young man right here has a button and some temperatures. Let's see what we can figure out here. So probably whatever you're thinking turned out to be wrong. It took probably about 5 minutes to figure this out. I got real tickled with myself. Okay. After operating the different buttons here, I found out that none of the knobs do anything except for this one. And this one here turns on the shower. At least there's water coming out. So then now I reckon that probably this was my switch to go to the faucet. Which it was. Look at that raging torrent there. Alright. Then this, of course, is then the temperature control, and the button locks it so that you can't go too hot. It's like a scald control. Look at that. Look at that. Huh? Isn't that nice? Not entirely sure it was necessary to be so complicated, but there you go. And then my favorite part, the one that got me tickled, is that look at this. Look how hard this water is coming out, okay? So we're going to turn it down a little bit, make it a little bit more gentle. No, No, there is no gentility. And what's interesting about this is that you can dial it back at least a little bit, but if you do, you have to keep holding that, because if you don't, it sort of it automatically kind of kicks itself over into the stop position. So I don't know why it says pull down here, because as near as I can tell, you only have pull and off. But at least it's drinkable.
Oh boy.
Hey guys, hotel room tour time. Here's my lovely imposing black door with the standard gold. This device right here is the absolute bane of my existence every other country I go in, because you can see my key card is in there. This is what turns on all the power for the entire room, including the air conditioner. Which means when I leave in the afternoon, when I leave the room, if I don't jam it with something, then my air conditioner turns off, and as you all know, that is no good for me. And the maids here will take out whoever's business card it is that you block it with, and very politely lay it somewhere else so that the air conditioner turns off. So you gotta be watching. You're greeted by some disposable slippers there, if you'd like to take those. And get ready, it's massive. Here it is, the whole room. This is a full-size bed. I'm sorry it's a little messy. I've been traveling for 30 hours, and I got up it after only like 2 hours of sleep to start that travel. So yeah, when I got here, I just passed out. Nice television. It's it appears even bigger than that, because you have to sit so close to it. It's a good view. I'll show you that in a minute. And this is it. This is my hotel room. Messy as it is.
Hey guys, it's your boy TbeariusAndrew. It's about 4 o'clock in the morning here, and I'm up because I slept as soon as I got off the plane. It was a brutally long day, because I went to bed at about midnight. 11:30, and I had to get up at 2 or 2:30 to start my journey, because my flight was at 6:45 a.m. So I had no sleep for basically the last 36-48 hours, however long it's been. I get confused with the time here, but anyway, and I did sleep a couple of maybe dozed for a total of like an hour on the plane, 2 hours on the plane. I don't sleep on planes very well. So yeah, and then I got to here, and I had to get on a train, and I had to come here and find my hotel and all that. So I posted a video of Shibuya when I got here, and you can see just the raft of people that greeted me when I arrived, and just people everywhere. All right, so. Dig, if you will, this picture. I told you all of that I just told you to explain that I have been traveling all day today with these two backpacks stuffed to capacity. My hiking clothing backpack here is 50 liters, and it is absolutely stuffed to capacity. I kid you not. And then this laptop bag over here basically has everything that wouldn't fit into the other bag here. So the way that I chose to travel with this is to be as mobile as possible. I put the hiking backpack on my back, and I put the laptop pack on my front, like a papoose. Well, I guess the papoose is on your back, isn't it? I don't know what goes on your front, but anyway, I was carrying a lot of stuff. So for the most part, it hasn't been that big of a deal for me today, other than the weight, because, you know, I've been in like airports and things like that, mostly open spaces, and the places that I have had to sort of, been in more of a like tight space situation, I've been able to just take one off and carry it. But when I arrived here at Shibuya, I was stuck, because I needed to be able to find my hotel. and I needed to walk there. I knew it was a few blocks away. But there were so many people that it was, I knew it was going to be a problem to walk around with my backpack. But there's nothing I can do because here I am. I can't go buy a new bag. I mean, there's nothing you can do. You can't get them anything. So I emerge into Shibuya's scramble crossing there. And I'm going to get a picture, a video of it in the morning because it's just absolutely unbelievable. It's like the busiest intersection in the world. And just there are so many people. And they cross this street and just waves going this way and waves going that way because it's like a multi input sort of a situation. So I was about halfway through walking across this road, and I'll again dig, if you will, this picture. I got this enormous backpack on my back, got this enormous backpack on my front. I am an enormity myself, and so I have no idea where I'm going. I've got the address of the hotel plugged into this plugged into my phone. So I'm walking around with my phone and I'm looking and I don't know what I'm doing. And why do people give you directions to find things with like compass directions? Like if I'm using Google Navigator, I'm clearly lost. Like I clearly don't have a clue. And you know, I would think that my phone should be intelligent enough to know that I have been, you know, I'm generally in the United States, in the Midwest, and now I'm in Shibuya, in Tokyo, on the other side of the world. Maybe I don't just happen to know which direction is south. So maybe telling me to walk south is the stupidest possible thing you could possibly say to me in that moment. But anyway, I'm walking around. I got a huge backpack on my front. It says, I'm 6'5". I'm not a small 6'5". Not going to blow away in the wind. Let's put it that way. So I'm 6'5" tall. I am 2.5-3 feet wide, the shoulders. And for the first time ever in my life, I'm going to have to give like my depth dimension because I'm probably about 4 feet deep also because I've got my normal, again, not going to blow away in the wind self. I got this enormous backpack making a great big circle out in front of me and another enormous backpack making a great big circle out behind me. And I'm walking through all of these poor Japanese people that know where they're going. Oh, and I'm staring at a phone, not really looking where I'm going. With Siri or somebody screaming at me, left, now go two lefts and then go a right. And so anyway, I can see on the screen where I am and I can see on the screen where the hotel is and I can see where I'm walking and it's just a circle around something that I can only assume she was trying to get, because the city's kind of built in levels, and I can only assume that she was trying to get me like up a level to like a main road so I could go. Anyway, I'm completely lost and I'm just in the middle of this enormous Shibuya crossing and I'm just circling, just a great big circle. And I realized I'm that guy. Like I am the person that Japanese people think of when they think of that dumb foreigner. And I'm just stumbling around. All these people are trying to walk. I'm like blocking their way. A couple of people, oh, it's so embarrassing. A couple of people stop and like bow to me after I block their way. So anyway, I got a taxi. I couldn't deal with it. I found the nearest taxi stand which was at like a mall or something. And I got a taxi. And so the taxi guy, he's just telling me, he's like, well, I think what he told me, because my Japanese is not so good, but I think what he told me was, you know, it's really close, right? So it's just going to be like a flat rate. So he told me it's just going to be like 790 yen, which is like the the equivalent of like $7, and he literally drives me like two blocks. He literally drives me two blocks, and he's like, okay, here it is. Like, we spent more time sitting waiting for a red light to change than the actual journey part of the trip. So yeah, I consider myself to be, you know, at least slightly more, I don't know, with it, world traveler than just your everyday standard person. But yeah, fail. Epic. Huge. Disappointing. Failure. What you gonna do? Good morning, everyone. Ohio with the Moss. It's me again. I am awake and I am cleaned up and I'm dressed and I'm ready to strike out on my adventure day here in Tokyo. So my plans today are my main plan today is to make my way over to a place called Harajuku, which is sort of like supposed to be like a scene destination. I don't know if you guys are familiar with that term, but scene, like goth and cosplay and all sorts of like those sorts of scenes like that. And so I want to head on over and check that out. There's also a very famous shrine there, I'm told, called the Meiji Shrine, which I'm going to try to hit up. But first, I'm going to have something to eat. And so when I was at the Shibuya train station walking in circles yesterday, I noticed a sign for Japanese Hooters. And I'm not really the biggest fan of Hooters, to be totally honest, but the I don't know when will ever be my chance to sort of try that out again, because I happen to be here by myself this time, so I'm not with anybody who, you know, really loves Japanese food and doesn't want to waste one of their meals in the motherland here because of you know, going to a Hooters. And you know, and I don't have any ladies with me, so I don't have to worry about offending anybody. So I'm gonna try out Japanese Hooters. So I'll talk to you later. Here we go. This is a kiosk where you buy train tickets to go everywhere. You see that map? That map tells you everywhere you can go, and then it has a price next to it. So you just feed that machine right there the price that it says, and you can go to that station. It's pretty impressive. But it's also kind of intimidating standing here right in front of it. Y'all ready for this? That. Wow. Seriously, pretty place. Let me get a 360 degree view of this. It's raining, hence all the umbrellas. The city over there. It's quite a thing to just turn a corner and there it is. Look at this, just tree lined walk down through here. Look at this tree lined walk. It is just really, really something. Get you another 360 here. It's hard to believe that there's a
huge city right on the other side of those trees we just looked past. You'd feel like you were deep in the woods somewhere. Really something, really something. Alright, so I guess up through that last gate there ahead of us must be the main major shrine. So I walked through a couple of gates like that, give you another 360 degree look. This really is a pretty park. Can't get over it. I know it must be a pretty park because I went and visited some office buildings that were built in here. Sorry about that, whoever runs those. The little lady at the front desk had to muster up all her English to tell me this is not the shrine. And I needed to keep walking. Actually, I guess this is like the main courtyard or whatever. It was the gate that I walked through, the last sort of gate. Leading into here. The journey continues that way. Walking away now. I visited the major shrine, so it's behind me. The actual shrine doesn't allow pictures. At least there was a sign that said no pictures. So I just washed my hands with the purifying fountain like you're supposed to do, and then I threw some money into an offering box. And you're supposed to bow twice, so I did. Clap twice, so I did. And then bow again. So I observed other people doing it to make sure I do it right. And I did it. So hopefully we paid the proper respects to all of the spirits. No matter what your religion is, never hurts to show respect, I think. So there you go. Major Shrine. We headed back towards Harajuku train station.
Well, hello, boys and girls. It's Travis, and I have arrived at my hotel in the Philippines in the lovely city of Clark. Took us about 3 hours to get here from Manila because of traffic, and I think it's time for a room tour. And I have to say, this room is really very nice. It's really something special. I'll give you a little bit of a look around there. Here's the bed. You can see this lovely little dining nook over here. Nice. I haven't tried that bed out yet, but it looks very, very comfortable. And wait until you see this bathroom. From the outside, you can't really tell much, but as you get inside, you see that there's very nice accommodation of everything. There's a sink. Little mirror, some glass shelving. This shower is very nice. Tucked back here around the corner. Haven't tried that out yet. That'll get broken in the morning. And look at this. A telephone right by the throne. So that's nice. The only small thing I see about it is that its bathroom is separated from the main by this lovely sliding. Let me back up so you can see it. Lovely sliding pocket door there with these slats in it. So, yeah. The only potential issue I see is you might not want to be sitting in there just destroying it while somebody was out here trying to watch TV, but since I'm alone, won't be a problem. So that's my hotel in Clark. It's actually on the estate of like a golf resort. There's a casino in the hotel. There's a bar downtown, down in the lobby with live music. Very, very nice place. This totally makes up for that. My hotel in Japan was very nice, but it was very small, and this just very, even maybe appears even larger by comparison. All right, well, thanks for going on this journey with me, and here we go.
Hey guys, it's your boy TbeArius. This is my last night here in the Holiday Inn in Clark. I'm all packed up. Oh, my glasses are crooked. I'm all packed up here and ready to go, and I just wanted to make one little video here just to commemorate the experience. I'm gonna give a quick look around my room, because not only is this my last night here, but the power just went out. All right. So, just thought I would take a minute just to, check in here. I haven't made many videos here in Philippines, mostly because I've, not really been alone much when I was here, and, looks a little weird to be walking around making selfie videos. But I want to make this last one because this is sort of a momentous occasion. We're not only is it my last night here in the beautiful Holiday Inn, it was actually the last night of the beautiful Holiday Inn. It's closing. So this is their last night of operation. They're supposed to shut down. My television just turned on because the power blinked a minute ago. This is the last night of the operation here. So I'm just gonna see if I can get this television off. I'm just gonna give you a quick look around my room here, a little bit from where I'm standing. Look at the artwork. Oh my, nice pretty lime green walls. You can't go wrong with lime green. Look at that. Oh my, nothing more tropical than good old lime green. So anyway, tomorrow we leave here. We will work a half a day, and then we're gonna work our way to Manila. And then we'll begin the, on the following day, we'll begin the long journey home. So maybe I'll give you another video when I get there with some of my final thoughts on this trip. What I will say now is that this trip has yet again taught me that the world is much larger, a more diverse and more interesting place than most of us will ever realize. And as I've said many times, there's so much that you don't know until you have the experience to travel around it a little bit. So I've had a wonderful time here, and I thank everyone who's been associated with my time in the Philippines and my time in Japan. And yeah, notch it down as another life adventure. So, I'll sign off. Everybody have a good night. Hello again, it's me. Welcome to the Ducet Hotel in Manila. It's a very, very, very nice place. We just arrived here. Traffic is insanity. I'll see if I can get a little glimpse out the window over there.
I hope you can see that, because I have the phone where I can't see. That's the view outside my window. There's the pool down below me. Very pretty place.
Been a long trip. I'm ready to go home, but it's a very pleasant place to spend our last night before we start the, I think it's going to be about a 23-hour trip to get back to the U.S. So I'm looking forward to doing that tomorrow. But until then, Mama's baby is coming up in the world. This is a really nice hotel. Talk to y'all when I get stateside. Hey guys, it's me. It's currently 8 p.m. in the Eastern time zone of the U.S. and I am finally reporting in from my very own couch in my very own apartment here in back in the States. So when I last time I got out of a bed, it was 4 a.m. in Manila, which should have been 4 p.m. on Friday, and which should have been 4 p.m. on Thursday here. It's now 8 p.m. on Friday here, meaning that I've been traveling for 28 hours, I believe. And I have to say that for me, I dearly, dearly hate the travel part of going overseas. Because that 28 hours is it's just, you know, it's flying and being uncomfortable with, intermixed with, you know, loading yourself up with all your bags and whatever airport you're making transitions in, and trying to go through security and answer questions and get your passport out and fill out this form, get your passport out again and fill out that form, and then get back on the, and then go through security and take your laptop out, take your shoes off, get back and pack everything back up. It's just a huge hassle. But in all fairness, I would like to say that that is balanced out by the fact of all the wonderful people that you get to see and work with. This is my first experience of going to the Philippines. I have to say that there's no more giving, nice people than I met in the Philippines. And I really thank all of them for all their support. And of course, my friends in Japan that I saw while I was there, old friends and new friends. That was a really fantastic time. So, you know, in the end, it's all worth it to travel, and, you know, and also, how lucky am I to get to see these places and experience these things. So, yeah, it's a really wonderful experience, but I'm also really, really happy to be home. Home and happy.